Hey, welcome to Tony Hawk's Underground. I'm just playing this now for my review, which will go up tomorrow in your time, but I'm still kind of in the middle of the game as I record here. I've been having a good time with this game, but I do think it does have some problems. I would like to see them revisit this idea, maybe, but let me show you. So recently, I just had to do a challenge where I had to drive this thing around and run over piles of leaves. And it took like 3 minutes because I had to drive up here. Oh, there, I got that one. Okay, now I gotta drive all the way up here. Now down at the end, there's another one. And you just go and you go and you go and you do this boring crap that you don't care about. And you do that a lot. There's so much about this game that is just filler that I just don't care about. But at this point, there still is a lot of positives. I think the story is pretty cool. I don't know if I'm gonna go too much into it in the review. I don't think so, but I recently got to the part where Eric stole my footage. And as you may notice, I am a green barefooted girl. And Eric Sparrow took my footage and said that it was him. It's kind of completely ridiculous that that would be possible. But there was also a challenge I had to do. So right before the premiere, this one guy is too drunk to film this part that he wanted to do where he did a bunch of nollies. And it's just an excuse to like teach you how to do nollies, even though this is way too far into the game to be learning that. And it's just funny. He says, "Don't worry, I won't film your face, but I'm green." It's pretty ridiculous. All right. So what's going on right now in the story is that I turned pro, but the problem is I asked my buddy to help me pick out a house, and he was like, "A house? You can't make any money." Oh, yeah, I do it in order. But he says, "What, you're not making any money being a pro. Like, you have to actually get a shoe deal to make any money." So that is what I'm doing right now. I'm working on my shoe deal. Let's see, Circa, big on academics, of course. Wait, what? Why do I keep doing it wrong? The R is over there. So I gotta do, see? I? Stay away from that. That's weird. Where can I do this C first? C, I, R, C. Come on. All right. Okay, so I had to get a shoe sponsor so that they would pay for me to go on my deck tour. Which doesn't make a ton of sense. Okay, so... Oh, this crap again. Alright. How many times have I had to do this? Oh, right before the premiere, I had to pick up all of the people. Which is exactly like this, except it's in a car. And then you gotta do... Grab this and grab that and find all the Slam City Jam t-shirts. And all that kind of stuff. It's kind of funny, like, there's so many pros that are related to this series that they could talk to and, like, get an idea of what it's actually like. It's kind of funny, like, your filmer, he looks nothing like a skateboarder at all. He's like a filmer guy. Oh, I had to... I was trying to not hit that bus, but that was the whole point. And your filmer is not a skateboarder. He doesn't look like he has anything to do with skateboarding. And it's kind of funny that they seem to have kind of the wrong idea about how the skate industry works in a lot of ways. Like, for this example, my shoe sponsor is going to send me... My shoe sponsor is going to send me... How do I stop it? On my deck tour, and that doesn't really make any sense. All right, so I have to, I imagine maybe I have to like wall ride it or something. I'm not sure. Yeah, this is so I think this is kind of before... This is before the Tony Hawk series really got in with Nokia phones. I don't know if you remember that. Hey, come on. So annoying. You'll find yourself doing a lot of this bullcrap you don't care about, and this is the ones that you'll get stuck on. I was just in Hawaii, and I was trying to climb this building, and it took me forever. I couldn't figure out where the ladder was supposed to be, and I just kept getting stuck doing the same thing over and over and over, but it's not a skateboarding challenge. It's like a jump up and down on crap challenge. So is there something I can drop into? No, there's not. One of my problems, I might not have the speed stat. I'm sure I'm doing it wrong, but one cool thing about the way this game works is that you build your stats up by doing stuff. So I bump into it. I don't even know what I'm supposed to do here. But you build your speed stat up by doing stuff. And I think the speed one is just like getting a high score. I'll just show you real quick. So these are the little challenges you have to do. Oh, I'm pro now, so I have all these ones. There are extra ones now. So land an 800,000 point combo would be the only thing I could do to get my speed higher. But it's really not bad. Guess I'll just keep trying it. Maybe if I could like sketch it or something. Alright, here we go. We'll ride the bus. What do I have to do? There are a lot of frustrating moments in this game. A lot of story stuff, a lot of like, oh no, your team is like, okay, your team is like passed out drunk. You need to go wake them all up. And again, it's not skateboarding related. It's like, you know, you have to climb up on something and climb a ladder and then jump over a gap. Alright, so, let's see. I remember this level being really, really hard. You had to get, like, a hangover cure. Again, something drinking related. And you had to collect all this kind of stuff by going through this line. But, probably not gonna do that one today. So, as you can see, I'm, doing pressure flips. Which were such a bad idea. I did my video on pressure flips a little while back, and I like the trick. I have no problem with the trick. It's just so annoying the way they did it, where it's easier to do a pressure flip than an ollie, because the first time you hit it, you go into pressure stance, and then you have to hit it twice to go in an ollie stance. But so many of the pressure flips either take longer than other tricks, or I don't know, they're not practical. You bail doing them all the time, so you just have to get used to hitting the left trigger twice. I'm playing on the Xbox, by the way. That's why it's in 720p. But, man, how do I do it, Casper? Because I have to work on my stats a little. No. 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 Nope. 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 Come on. Nope. 1 foot manual? Come on. Whatever. Let's just see what's going on over here. Hey, American. Some what's up? American company installed we Russians value privacy and would like them. Okay. Another ridiculous excuse for doing a combo. Ugh. And again, this is something where you just kind of have to learn where they are. So I know I have to grind that, and then the next ramp I gotta go up. There's no way to know that without just doing it a bunch of times. So weirdly, this is actually not the line that I was talking about. That was for something else. Okay. So when you get these big, the orange stars, it is a pro. Tony Hawk. So I think he's gonna teach me something. Too late, comrade. I'll tell you what, you give it a try. Land tricks until you get your special 360 varial heel flip lean. So laser flip, is that what you're saying? Yep. Okay, thanks, Tony. I do like the way that it gives you specials like that. Because one thing I never bothered to do, I know it's just my own laziness, is every time I would unlock a special trick slot in the earlier games, I would never bother to put anything in there. So I am getting some special tricks like that, which is actually called a Daffy, by the way, when you manual on two boards like that. This is called a Daffy, but they do it in the Yeah Right video, so they call it a Yeah Right manual. I don't know, it's one of those things. One of those things where the original name gets lost because, I mean, I don't know why. It fits on screen better, too. Like, there's no good reason to change the name. But, anyway. There's a lot more customization options in this game. You can make your own deck. So I have, I don't know, it gets, like, worn off. I don't know. I put an R on it, and I made it orange and stuff. I try to kind of make it look like a Radarap, but I don't want to spend too much time on it, because I know you play the game for, like, 5 minutes, and it'll go away. But you can make your own tricks, too, which is really lame, and I hate it. So let's not do that, and let's, again, instead talk to this guy.
It takes a little high. Saw caveman onto it.
Caveman. Okay. So the caveman stuff is really weird because... The caveman stuff is really weird because your skill at cavemans makes it so that you can have a longer timer when you step off. Like I don't understand what that would mean in skateboarding, like in real life. Like you can run in such a way where it really looks like you're still skating. I don't know. All right, there's Bam. I don't know why. Is that actually Bam? Because... Down here. Distract the... You're at phase three of... Operation Decoy. Oh, come on. Oh, yeah, okay. Because you get to pick what team you're on, and of course, Bam should have been on only Element, which I did not pick. But anyway, there he was. Dang it, dead. There's a lot of weird stuff. I know this time it didn't tell me I have to do it in a combo, but a lot of times you'll have to, and it's kind of weird. You know, like, oh, you have to go pick up all these stickers you dropped, but make sure you do it in a combo. And that's kind of where I think the, a ladder. Okay. You get to see me try to work this control. Oh, instantly failed. Oh boy. This is the most frustrating part of the game by far, is this kind of crap. No, stay up here. You can do it. Oh, I gotta go over there. So the easier thing would be to just do that. Okay. I guess that wasn't too bad. Okay, Bam Margera, we got it. So funny. So they do a good job in this game of actually changing things up. So being able to open the gate and then changing the time of day and unlocking new areas, and then you... When we do the demo, there will be new ramps and stuff that go up. And that's pretty cool, because these levels are pretty big, but there's still a lot to do. And it's cool that they are able to change it up so much.
Hey there. Why are these reporters bugging you?
Once I was in the circus. I could put my ankles...
What kind of stupid excuse is that? But yeah, you do a lot of freestyle in this game. Oops. Which is kind of cool that they, you know, they put in the effort of putting it there, so why not? Come on. My balance stat is not very good, and if I can only figure out how to do a Casper like that. Wait, get 30,000 points in a manual combo. I just did 45,000. I don't get it. Did it mean 300 or? What am I supposed to do? Do you see that? Get 30,000 points in a manual combo. I don't know. That's really weird. I've never had something just not work. Okay, there's 40,000. Nothing. What the heck? That is really weird. Okay, maybe I do nothing but freestyle. No ollieing. That's not gonna work. I'm trying to show her how much of a contortionist I am for some reason. You know, it's kind of funny. There's a lot of like proof that, okay, so that was it. I just couldn't ollie. Yeah, like that. She said she'd show me some tricks if these people weren't around. There's a lot of times where you either have to flirt with girls or they flirt with you, and it's clearly not designed for you to be a girl, which is funny because they clearly allow it, you know. But there's one where the party was a sausage fest, and I had to pick up a bunch of girls, and I had to impress them with my skills. But it's just kind of funny. I already did something with the reporter over there. Okay. This kind of stuff, they at least made an effort. Like, it's just a high score thing, you know? But they actually went out of their way to make it special. Like, it's kind of hard to see what I'm doing, but they at least did that, which is nice. But there are a lot of really annoying challenges. One thing that's new in this game, which this reminds me of because it looks the same, is that you actually have to film other people, which just means you have to ride next to them, and the screen will look like this, and you just have to ride next to them and not let them get away, which is so pointless. It's incredibly easy, and it's really boring. So not every new thing that they did is worth it. All right. See, now there's some ramps there, like they're setting up. So that's pretty cool. So I need what? I need 400,000 total. I think that's all spots. If I can get it here, maybe I just have to like ride to the other one or something. Keep figuring out how to do Caspers on accident. Sometimes it's easy to get really high score just doing freestyle. Not always. Okay. Oh, okay. Well, I don't know how I got that exactly, but I did. Good job, me. Randy Mullen, hey, what's up? Why are you hanging out here? He's not on my team, but he just always shows up wherever I am. Okay. Oh, Casper, XY. Cool, okay. I think they did a good job of how they do the freestyle in this game. Not just the way it's handled in the story, but also the way that they named everything. There's very few mistakes in it. Oops. And I think a lot of the times they're like Rodney approved mistakes, like a name was changed, like truck stand isn't what it used to be called, that kind of stuff. So I have to do... Ooh, that's gonna be tough. I have to do 5 Caspers in a combo, and then I will get a speed or a stat increase, or 6 times. Cool. Now, something that the game really doesn't tell you about, the way that you get your stats, you'll just happen to do one on accident, and you'll suddenly realize that that kind of stuff exists. But some of it'll be like, that Casper one, I probably could have done that easier. Like, I could have done that before. But I just didn't know about it.
Show me how well you know Moscow.
Find gaps? Okay. That's kind of weird. One thing I never got into in the Tony Hawk series is gaps. Like, people will try to collect, get all these different gaps and stuff. So you may have seen the secret tape up there. I'm still playing the game. I haven't actually gotten one of those yet, so I'm not even sure what happens when you get one. I wonder if you do you actually unlock a video. Well, by the time you answer me, I'll know. But let's see. Is that a gap? No. Is this a gap? No. I think the 360 flips in this game are actually a bit better. In 4, I think that's when they first did like the double tap thing for him, and it did not turn out all that well. But I think they did a better job this time. Come on, give me a gap for something. This is one of those especially frustrating ones. Just because it's not skill-based. Okay, so that's not a gap. That could have been a gap. I did nothing wrong in attempting to do that. I didn't, you know... I just... No. Smashing a snowman, is that a gap? No. About switching from side to side. No, nothing? Okay. That would have been a gap if I made it. Yeah, so ran out of time. One of my other challenges is half cap impossibles. Which is a fun trick. Oh, dang it. Oh, well. What else we got going on? What are you jerks doing? Oh, one update to this game is this. You can actually jump right to a challenge, which you've never been able to do before. That guy, the worst. He told me my footage that he stole got lost in customs. Although he used it, so... No excuse, Eric. You jerk. I'm gonna tell your mom. Let's see. Oh, I thought I was going to be, Okay, I thought he was gonna do all the tricks they call out. They go so freaking slow. Okay. $20,000. I think we'll be able to get that. I like how casually we just destroy everything. We're just busting through all this glass. We'd probably be in some dark Soviet prison right now. Oh, he's drunk. This happens so much in the story.
Your license good in Moscow. Oh, Vlad told me he's okay to take your time.
Don't tell me I have to drive this thing. I hate driving stuff in this game. It is the worst.
Ben's gonna be so jealous when he finds out about this.
Dude, stop it.
Well, here I am, ready to drive. Let me guess, he's gonna bail on me. Oh, come on, guy.
Come on, Eric. Oh, Eric, come on, man. Open this thing. Let me out. Man, come on. Eric!
Dead. Game over. Just got murdered.
When I saw her steal the guard's key.
I don't actually remember this part of the story.
I tried to stop her, but she wouldn't listen.
There are $700,000 in damages you're responsible for, no?
No, absolutely not. I mean, not me. This kid doesn't even skate for us anymore. Get the check from the parents. The kid's off the team.
Of course.
The MC has freed you. Too bad your team has left you here to rot.
How much of this game do I have left? In general, I'm enjoying it, but enough is enough at some point. Alright, let's see. There's a star over here, right? One cool thing you'll now see, I used to have a girl logo. I was on the girl team. Now it's just like a crossbones. So, like, a car. Yes, let me drive a car. Yep, I love Russian women. See what I'm talking about?
You like Russian car?
Picking up girls again? I seriously already did this. But I was saying, like, the branding of all the logos and stuff changes. Where is she? Oh. Is that a girl? I thought that was a dude. That looked like a dude. Is that the joke? That Russian women look like dudes? Fetch me Tatiana. Duh. Hello. Where you at? This is a long news report. Yes, yeah, another one of those challenges that's just boring. Like, let's say I don't get the last one on time. I'm like 2 seconds late. It's just gonna be a chore to redo it, you know? Oh, that one was actually a girl this time. Svetlana. Sometimes these are really easy, and I'll do it with like a minute left. And then sometimes you'll have to get every turn perfectly. There's one where, dang it, I don't know if I'm gonna make it. There's one where you have to race around the block and you're like being chased by cops and stuff. And you have to do it perfectly. Ugh, this is terrible. Come on, come on, come on. Good. I got there. I killed them all. But I got there. Okay, how do I get home now? I do kind of like the story of this game. It's a lot better than in Tony Hawk 4 because there's all these little story elements that don't really do anything. This one at least... Oh, is this the one I was talking about? This one I remember being so freaking hard. That was a good start, huh? But there's all these story elements in 4 that just kind of sucked. But this one, at least, it's a thing. You know, it's a completed story. maybe it's not the most amazing thing I've ever seen in my life, but it works. I think this one is a lot better than Underground 2, which I'm not really looking forward to playing. Oh, sure, now I got gaps for days, huh? Come on, get back on track. Dang it. It's so dark on screen that I can't even tell that there's a gap in that rail. Come on. Where's the next one? So I'm playing on hard mode or expert difficulty, or I don't remember what it calls it, but I'm definitely playing on hard mode here. And this is the type of challenge, dang it, where this would come into play. Yep, okay, I remember this part, and I remember it not going well for me. Yeah, that was it. I don't remember how to get up there. Dang it. Yeah, so I'm screwed. You're just riding along, and then you suddenly have to be somewhere else. Don't know how to get up there. I don't know where it is. Oh, and I'm out. Yeah, see, it's over. And so I was how far into that challenge when it hits me with something I'm not expecting, and then I'm just done. I hope I don't have to do that one. There's something else I can do. This one?
Hello, America. We hear you need to get out of Russia.
This is exactly like the one with the girls. Hello! How are you? See, what does this have to do with skateboarding or anything? It's just, this could be any game. But no other game would do something that's this lame. I mean, look what I'm doing. I'm just riding around and running into people with a green fist over their head. I don't know why.
Alexander sent you, eh?
It kind of looks like Steve Caballero. A little older, though.
Put this magnet on your board. Two spins over the roof.
Okay, let's see. Glad I worked on my spin stat a little, but I can only do one. I can do a 540. I can't do a 720, which would make this go double the speed. The spins are really, really, really slow in this game. Yeah, I tried a 720, it didn't work out for me. In the beginning of the game, if you can get like a 360 on a vert wall, it's pretty good. One other issue, don't do that. Another issue I have with the game is the fact that there's so many tricks. There'll end up being a lot that you'll do on accident. You know, you accidentally do a special trick or something like that, and you end up just getting stuck all the time. So you can hold that Ollie North like a grab, and then you just get stuck if you're not paying attention. If you're trying to watch where you're going or something like that. Oops. Am I even gonna get this? Come on. I don't think I'm gonna make it. Nope. So this would have been better to do literally any other way. The fact that I have to do it 20 times, and if I restart, I just have to do it again. It's so tedious. So I'm trying to do tricks just to keep myself entertained, but that's what makes me screw it up. 360 Ollie. 360 Ollie. I'll I'll get it done this way, but it's really boring. So during my gameplay for the reviews, what I've been doing in times like this, I would just stop recording because it's so boring. I have like hours of me riding around in circles. I don't even know if I'm gonna make it this time either. Really have to take a minute and work on my stats. Something else I don't really feel like doing because I'm not really getting anything accomplished. As far as the channel and as far as like getting the review done. Always time to fail, though. Alright.
Thank you for ending the meeting.
Okay. So, was that not enough to go? Oh, I have to do the Hangover one. Okay. Well, you know what? I'm just gonna go ahead and not do that. I'll do it some other time. Thanks for watching. Check out my full review of this game tomorrow. And subscribe so that you don't miss anything else. I'm gonna try to branch out from Tony Hawk a little more pretty soon, but stay tuned for that. I've also got all kinds of other videos about all kinds of different skateboarding topics that you can check out pretty much every single day. So thanks for watching this, and I'll see you tomorrow.